I'm Jeannie Satterfield.
And I'm Josh Satterfield.
We've been married for 8 years, mm-hmm. and we are natives of Greenville, South Carolina, born and raised. We love the upstate.
We do.
About 9 years ago, I had viral meningoencephalitis, which is an infection of the lining of the brain, but also inside of the brain as well. So the scar tissue has caused me to have epilepsy, and we've tried for several years to control it with medication, and it failed.
About two-thirds of patients can have their seizures fairly easily controlled with one or two medicines. Once patients, though, have seizures despite a couple kind of standard medicines, the majority actually have difficult to control epilepsy.
Sometimes it would be just a strange smell all of a sudden, or a strange taste in my mouth, or just a weird feeling that would just wash over through my head, neck, and my chest. But sometimes it lasts for just a few seconds and it's gone. That was my warning sign that I was about to have a complex partial seizure. And my complex partial seizures were swallowing repetitively or biting.
She was having variable numbers of seizures, but usually about one seizure a week. And it was interfering with work, she's unable to drive. Her husband's very worried about her.
It had taken everything she had for that day just to make it through to that point. So she would come home and crash and just be tired from that. You know, she wants to do more. She wants to enjoy life more than that. You know, just making it through a day is no way to live.
And so when I saw her, she had failed several standard anticonvulsants and had frequent seizures. And so we admitted her to our seizure unit to localize her seizures and see whether she could have epilepsy surgery. And so patients who want to consider surgery and have failed several standard drugs, we bring them in. They're usually not having daily seizures, and we usually need 3 or 4 seizures. So we're very slowly lower the medicines while they're in until we capture several seizures. Then we remedicate them. And then we put a large number of electrodes on the scalp above the brain and pinpoint their seizures.
They decided that I was a good candidate for surgery because they could localize where my seizures originated from.
I first met Jeannie and her family after they had been visiting with Dr. Krause and the epilepsy team about possible therapies that we could offer to help her with her seizures. At that time, we were leaning toward performing a surgery called a temporal lobectomy, which would address the issues that she was having in her right temporal lobe left over from her viral infection. You know, we talked about what the procedure was like. We talked about how much hair has to be shaved, what the skin incision looks like, what to expect in terms of the amount of pain after the procedure, and how fast they can get back on their feet.
Yeah, it was very scary, but I knew that I didn't want to live like that for the rest of my life. I didn't want to be on all of that medication and live a tired life all of the time.
It was very dramatic, even not long after surgery as she recovered, how much more energy she had.
I do like being outside. I can enjoy it a lot more now because I'm not on the sofa at night anymore.
She did very well with the surgery and really had no problems with dexterity or speech issues after the surgery. And what is truly profound to me and certainly meaningful to me is how well she's done with the surgery. She still remains seizure-free at this point and is really moving on with her life and doing quite well.
She's wanting to do more. We're enjoying spending time, you know, outside the house, which was a big change from the past, 7 or 8 years. We'd rather laugh about something than cry about something.
You've seen me at my worst, my very worst, and stuck with me through it.
Everybody has up days and down days. We've had our share of both, and Jeannie's had her share of down days for sure through all of this, but we just look forward to having more good ones going forward.